pandemic, especially within the context of the speech, we all learned that nothing is guaranteed, ever. Not safety, not happiness, not life. Our planned futures aren't even promises. This past fall, my plan was to attend Mississippi State in pursuit of a degree from veterinary medicine, and I was so set and certain on that future. That plan changed. I fell in love with the vet clinic that I am working at now, and with the life I have here in Alabama right now. I didn't want to leave. I'm training as a vet tech and staying where I am. That's my current plan, but now I know that that plan might change someday, too, and that's okay. To my classmates, both graduating today and not, I implore you, do not let chances slip away. Take advantage of every opportunity that crosses your path, because that opportunity may not come back around tomorrow. Do not fear the unknown or the seeming impossibility of immediate success hinder you. Do not let it hinder you. It will never become known to you unless you learn it, and you will never learn if it's possible if you don't try it. Tomorrow is not a promise, but a chance. Class of 2021, our steps forward from this moment are not a straight path, but a winding road. Each twist and turn is a chance to make a difference, to learn about ourselves and others, and discover God's will for each of us in our lives. Thank you again for your support, time, and attention.
I'm going to turn over the podium to Miss Elizabeth Carr, our valedictorian.
Thank you for that introduction. Well, we made it. All of our years of hard work have paid off. We are no longer children with big dreams. We stand here today as high school graduates, an accomplishment that deserves celebration. Through late night studying and early morning risings, we've all completed an important step of our lives. But what comes next? Tomorrow, we will wake up as high school graduates with a future that we can mold just waiting for us. Tomorrow, our future begins. We are adults in a world that parents and elders have prepared for us. But today, let us think back to the lessons we have learned throughout our high school years that will help us as we move on to the new phase of our life. More specifically, the lessons that we found most important that weren't found through books, but were found through experience. Here are a few of my personal favorites. The first lesson I would like to point out is to create your own opinion on issues. I believe that before each of us go into the world, that we look deep inside ourselves and ask what we believe in. Not what our parents told us to believe in, not what the world tells us to believe in, but what you value, what you believe. This belief should stick with you. Your values should follow you throughout your life and should influence how you see the world. Finding your own values outside of anyone else is one of the best lessons that I believe we can all learn. The second lesson goes along with it. Stand up for what you believe in. Use your voice. Having your own beliefs is good, but finding what you believe and standing up for them is better. Standing up for people who need your help. Standing up and using your voice for good causes. It's a privilege that we live in a generation and a world that we are able to speak up and use our voice. It's important that we use that privilege to speak up and to let others stand and help those who need our help. And now I challenge each of you to think back to the lessons you've learned throughout your life. Think about what inspired these lessons. And because of that, now we should give thanks. Because we wouldn't know these lessons without our wonderful mentors, teachers, and parents. First, a thank you to Constance, who has served so much of her time to help every single one of us find our voice and to help us get louder, even if we're yelling while cars are passing by the interstate. She helped us every step of the way. Next, a personal thank you to my family, my parents, who have helped me and most of the kids in my family and the people around us to find our voice, to let us continue to learn about the world without getting in our way and telling us what to believe. Next, from all of us, I think we can all agree when we say thank you to every single parent, family member, mentor that has served so much time to help us get our education and to help us all find our own voices. And now, to tomorrow, to the future.
By the roadside on Meridian Street during school traffic and try to give a speech that we can hear. In case you're wondering, that's not easy. Thank you for these kids. Thank you, Lord, for giving them hope and heart and love for their communities and their families. Thank you, Lord, for the families that invest so much time and energy and resources, blood, sweat, and tears into the education of these children. Lord, we thank you for the opportunity you lay before them. We ask that you keep them in your special care. Guide their paths. Show them the path you've chosen for them. And make it clear so that they know what you have in store for them. Lord, help us all be good stewards of our time together so that we can help them follow the path you've chosen. In Jesus' precious name we pray. And all God's children said,
All right. I want to congratulate the class of 2021. Now you can move your pencil from the right to the left, signifying that you are now high school graduates. Congratulations.
Thank you.
That's a fun looking bunch, isn't it? Get one more great big group shot. Everybody get out the cameras. Because you know you've all been waiting for that.
Wow.
All right. Congratulations, class of 2021 from Hope Christian Academy.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'm Pete. I appreciate your
Trista said that we're supposed to come see you. You had to.